So since I want to find the y value 0.5, I is equal to 1. X1 will be now equal to 0.25 because we're a step ahead. Y1 we just found out to be 10.25. And Z1 we just found out to be equal to 5.125. So if we write down the equation for Y2, Y2 is Y1 plus the value of the function F1 at X1, comma Y1, comma Z1 times H. Y1 we just found out to be 10.25 plus the arguments of this function F1 will be X1 is 0.25, Y1 is 10.25, and Z1 is 5.125. So 10.25, 5.125 times H, which is 0.25. And this value here, for the value of F sub 1, we get 10.25 plus the value of F1 is 5.125. The reason why that's the value, because F1 is nothing but the value of Z, which is 5.125, times 0.25. And this value here turns out 11.153. And that would be the approximate value of y at 0.5, because that's the value of y at x2 now, because that's y2. Y2 is the value of y at x2, and we know x2 is nothing but 0.5, because you've already gone from 0 to 0.25, and the next step is 0.5. So that's what we're looking for. So the final answer is that y at 0.5 is approximately equal to 11.153. So that's what you obtained here. So how do we know that is this, this is how accurate this answer is? So what we did was we conducted some, we found the value of y at 0.5 by using different values of h. Let me give you what the exact value of y at 0.5 is up to 5 significant digits. This is the exact value by using your ordinary differential equation calculus knowledge, ordinary differential equation knowledge, by using Laplace transforms or any of the classical solution techniques to find out what the exact value of this y at 0.5 is. So I'm going to leave that as homework, that you go ahead and find out, verify that the exact value is that for solving the ordinary differential equation, which I wrote in the beginning, the second order differential equation. Now, we did develop a table for different values of h for value of y at 0.5, and we want to just see that whether it converges or not. For h equal to 0.5, we just found out that the value at y at 0.5 is approximately 11.153. But then what we did was we have the step size, which means that we have to take 4 steps now. We got 10.639. So this can be a good homework for you to do to verify that when I use the step size of 0.125 that I get 10.639. And at 0.0625, I got 10.251. And for 0.03125, again, having the step size, I got 10.073. And of course, we know the exact value here is 9.9046. So that should give you some idea that how fast and whether it converges or not. It seems to converge by using smaller step sizes, but it is taking a lot more time, a lot more steps to reach the exact value here. And that's the end of this segment.